Good morning, everybody. Mother Jenna here with you this Monday in Easter week to pray morning prayer together. If you've been following morning prayer, if you've been praying with us through Lent, you know, or you might notice that today there'll be some fun changes to help us mark this season of resurrection, these great 50 days of Easter. I'll guide you through it. You might be using a bulletin in front of you that came in this email, or you might be using your prayer book. I do not have the bulletin in front of me, so I'm going to do my best to follow it, but I'm going to be using my prayer book, and I'll announce our pages as we go, and we will pray together. We'll start on page, sort of on 77, but really on page 80. I'll say a sentence from page 77, and then we'll move to page 80. So let's take just a minute to gather ourselves, and then we'll pray. Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. If you'll turn to page 83, we'll say together the Christ our Passover, the Pascha Nostrum, this great Easter text. Alleluia. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. Our Psalms this morning are Psalms 93 and 98. And Psalm 93 begins on page 722 in your prayer book, and then we'll skip to Psalm 98, which begins on 727. So we'll start with Psalm 93 on page 722 in your prayer book. Let's say it together. The Lord is King. He has put on splendid apparel. The Lord has put on his apparel and girded himself with strength. He has made the whole world so sure that it cannot be moved. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting. The waters have lifted up, O Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves. Mightier than the sound of many waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea, mightier is the Lord who dwells on high. Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness adorns your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore. And now Psalm 98, starting on page 727. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his right hand and his holy arm, he has won for himself the victory. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness he has openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel, and all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice, and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song. With trumpets and the sound of the horn, shout with joy before the King, the Lord. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth. In righteousness he shall judge the world and the peoples with equity. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We'll have our reading, which this morning comes from the Gospel according to St. Mark. Although I lost my marker, so give me 1 second. The reading for Easter Monday comes from St. Mark. Sorry, y'all, I'm getting there. My ribbon fell out. Here it is. From Mark chapter 16, verses 1 through 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He's not here. Look, there is the place they had laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. Here ends the reading. We'll say together Canticle 18, found on page 93 in your prayer book. Canticle 18, A Song to the Lamb. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain. For with your blood you have redeemed for God, from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so, to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. We'll continue with the Apostles' Creed, found on page 96 in your prayer book. We'll say it together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And we'll say suffrages A. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. I'll pray three collects. You don't have to turn to find these in your prayer book. I'll pray first the collect for today, for Monday and Easter week, and then two of our regular morning prayer collects. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who celebrate with awe the Paschal feast may be found worthy to attain to everlasting joys. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires. Incline our hearts to keep your law and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I kind of want to sing an Easter hymn for y'all, but I know that you're about to get a wonderful musical reflection, so I will control myself. But we'll continue our prayer with these guiding questions from St. Augustine's prayer book to help us pray our way through the day to come. In God's presence, think through the day ahead, the work you will do, the people you will encounter, the dangers or uncertainties you face, the possibilities for joy and acts of kindness. Any particular resolutions you need to renew. Consider what might draw you from the love of God and neighbor. The opportunities you will have to know and serve God and to grow in virtue. Remember those closest to you and all for whom you have agreed to pray ask God's blessings, guidance, and strength in all that lies before you. I invite any other prayers or intercessions or thanksgivings you may have, either silently or spoken out loud. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We'll continue on page 101 in your prayer book with the general thanksgiving, one of my favorites. We'll say it together. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us, to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Where are you going? Can you take me with you? For my hand is cold and needs warmth. Where are you going? Far beyond where the horizon lies, where the horizon lies and the land sinks into mellow blueness, oh please take me with you. Let me skip the road with you. I can dare myself. I'll put a pebble in my shoe and watch me walk. I can walk. I shall call the pebble dare. We will talk about walking. Dare shall be carried. And when we both have had enough, I will take him from my shoe, singing, meet your new road. Then I'll take your hand, finally glad that you are here. By my side. my side,
by my side,
by my side,
by my side.